وَالصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَىٰ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ. My dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is your brother Abdul Salam Abu Hanifa. Yesterday I spoke in the last pep talk about the accidents and destiny. And the worst moments of your life are not the hard, difficult, multiple situations you find yourself in today. Because nothing is ever built to last. And Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, as I have spoken before, every time He sends a calamity, a problem, He sends two solutions with it. It's just we humans, we concentrate on the problem and we forget the solutions. Whatever starts has got an end. This is why Allah has no beginning. Inherently, He doesn't have an end. He is perfect, subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know what's the worst situation, my brother and my sister, that you can ever find yourself in? Is that on judgment day, on the resurrection day, when you come to get your book, excited about all the prayers, all the actions that you've done, to get the reward, only to find out that you have wasted your time in this life building something that doesn't work. And you will be totally upside down. How did that happen? I did my Salat. I read my Quran. But where did I go wrong? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my dear brothers and my sisters, in Al-Quran, when He speaks about the non-believers and what they are going to get in the day of Qiyamah, don't make the mistake in thinking that you are not part of the threat in that ayah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks about people who do something, for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbade homosexuality. This is haram. Does that mean because I am a Muslim that I can do it and that Allah will forgive me when the non-Muslims, when they do it, Allah will punish them for it? Well, the answer is, you are equal in that crime with the believer and the non-believers. And if you thought differently, you are wrong. What is haram here is the act, not who does it, i.e. the status. Theft is haram because theft is haram, not against whom we do it. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Kahf, a very, very threatening, scary ayah. He says, قُلْ هَلْ نُنَبِّئُكُمْ بِالْأَخْسَرِينَ أَعْمَالًا الَّذِينَ ضَلَّ سَعْيُهُمْ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَهُمْ يَحْسَبُونَ أَنَّهُمْ يُحْسِنُونَ صُنْعًا. This ayah, my dear brothers and my sisters, as in the translation of the meaning, say, shall we news you of the greatest losers with what they performed? I know news you is not a verb, but it is the closest to translate the meaning or to give you the meaning of nunabbi'ukum. So shall we news you, give you the news of the greatest losers with what they have performed in this life? Obviously, all of us would ask, Ya Allah, please show us who are they, because we don't want to be part of them. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the meaning, those who endeavors and efforts were wasted in the life of dunya. Meaning they have done. They have strived and made efforts to accomplish. But Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says they are greatest losers. But why did they do that? It's because while thinking they were doing great deeds. I am today going to reveal with you, and I don't want to be a liar, but I would say probably 99% of you make this huge mistake. Huge. And this mistake, my dear brothers and my sister, is detrimental because it affects your Salat directly. Many Muslims today, they perform the Salat and their Salat is not accepted, even though they made wudu and even though they performed the Salat and even though they kept the Salat on time. But the Salat, wal-iyadu billah, and the wudu are not accepted. Why? because of a huge mistake in al-wudu. Before going to tell you what it is and why you should stop doing it and repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives you back the salat that you have performed before, because if you carry on like this, you are in a total danger. A lot of people have this misunderstanding that as long as the intention is good in my heart, the action is okay to suck, big deal. Then actually you are wrong. In Al-Islam, in this religion that Rasulullah ﷺ brought, and this religion that we all know, not the one you think you know, or the one you would love to know, or the one you've heard people speak. I'm talking here about the evidences in Al-Quran and the Sunnah. Because Allah says, وَلَوْ اتَّبَعَ الْحَقُّ أَهْوَاءَهُمْ لَفَسَدَتِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. If the truth was to follow your desires and what you want, then the heavens and the earth would have gone into chaos and corrupted. Now, whoever I speak to a Muslim who is doing something wrong, and he tell me, "Akhi, that is not halal, that is not," and he goes, "My intention is good." I don't care about your intention, I care about your action. That's what I care about. Your intention is with Allah, and there is not really an excuse that your intention is good and your action are evil. Because Allah says in the Quran, لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Our purpose in existence today is to be tested on the good, the best actions. And as it is explained in the Quran, فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكُ بِعْبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. Al-Hasan, the good word, is explained at the end of Surah Al-Kahf, that you must do an act good, and good here means either in the Quran or the Sunnah, without shirk to Allah. So when you have a good intention, but your action sucks, but your excuse is, "I have a good intention," I'm sorry, that's the loser's attitude. And you will be one of these people that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala has warned, and this is one of the most scariest ayah in the Quran. وَبَدَى لَهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ مَا لَمْ يَكُونُوا يَحْتَسِبُونَ. Surah Az-Zumar 47. And there will appear to them on the Day of Judgment from Allah that which they were not expecting. You make calculation, you expect something, on the Day of Qiyam, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala comes out to you with a different face altogether. You were not expecting, and then you cannot say, "Ya Allah, I thought that maybe I had a good intention." Allah will tell you, "I sent you my messenger to follow him in his deeds. Why did you choose not to follow him in the deeds? And you banked big deal that I will accept your wrong intention. I don't care how good is your intention." That's the danger, my brothers and my sisters. Before I go to this mistake that the majority of Muslims do, and that nullifies their wudu and nullifies consequently their salat, let me tell you how the Sahaba perceived the Rasulullah, and how I want you to perceive Rasulullah. When there was, I want you here to imagine there is no messenger. The world is like that. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala wants to be worshipped in a particular way. He wants this done, not that one, and so on and so forth. If He subhanahu wa ta'ala just sent us the Quran by itself, we would never ever have been able to perform it. Why? We will have an infinity of arguments and different points of view. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "I will create a human being, and I will take care of him. I will then teach him how to worship me, and then your job is to look at him how he worships me, and I want you to learn from him. And if you worship me, the closer you are to him, is the closer on how I want to be worshipped." Cool and dandy. سَمِعْتُمْ وَأَطَعْتُمْ قَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. We said, "Ya Allah, we heard and we shall obey." The Sahaba understood this. They understood that Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was a human being, but also was the role model on how Allah wants to be worshipped. Sometimes you think Rasulullah did it like that out of his own thinking. No. That's how Allah wants to be worshipped. So, they put that into practice. And those after them, they saw the Sahaba until our time. Today, alhamdulillah, we have the ahadith. So the sunnah of Rasulullah ﷺ is still alive with us. You today, you are telling me, I don't do what Rasulullah has done, but I have a good intention that Allah will accept. Well, Allah will not accept because you are not doing how the man who Allah said worshiping me like him has been doing, i.e. you are doing something out of your mind. My brothers and my sisters, even though we are Muslims, we must not fall in the trap of the shaitan. It's just when I say La ilaha illallah, I will enter Jannah. La ilaha illallah has got like 10 conditions that need to be fulfilled. None of them is saying it with the tongue alone. So I will go now with you and I will ask you a question about your wudu. How many times, or maybe I should not ask, I just go ahead and pinpoint the mistake because it's so painful. Once you realize the mistake, you must straight away stop from doing it, because the majority of the scholars, the great huge majority, have said that whoever performs the wudu this way, his wudu is void. Even if he wet himself or herself with water. And if the wudu is void, it means the salat is void. Some of us, some of you, have been performing salat for 15, 20 years, and that salat has not been accepted once. Scary thought. Really is. This is what is mentioned in the book of our Lord in Al-Ayah Al-Ma'idah, in Surah Al-Ma'idah. Al-Ma'idah. And that is in the ayah number 6. Ayah number 6. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defines the rules of the wudu. As you know, wudu is two parts. There is the wudu of the commands of Allah that is in the Quran, and the extra things are the sunnahs. If you decide to only do the wudu that is mentioned in the Quran and pray with it, your salat is accepted. What does Allah tell us about the wudu? He says, Ya أيها الذين آمنوا, you who have believed, إذا قمتم إلى الصلاة, when you stand up to get ready and you erect and you raise for الصلاة. And then he says, this is how I want you to do the wudu. فَأَغْسِلُوا وُجُوهَكُمْ, wash your faces. This is good. Everybody washes his face and alhamdulillah, everything. That is now the mistake that the majority of Muslims don't do. وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ إِلَى الْمَرَافِقُ, and your hands up to the elbows. The problem with this is, people wash their hands at the beginning of the wudu. That is a sunnah. That is not what is meant. If you don't wash your hands 3 times at the beginning of the wudu, it doesn't affect your wudu. However, after you have washed your face, a lot of people take water and they will wash from the wrist to the elbows without starting from the hands. And anyone who washes his wudu from the wrist to the elbows, that wudu is not accepted. Because the ayah says, وَأَيْدِيَكُمْ, and your hands from the tip of your fingers until the elbows. Which means in every wudu, you wash your hands with the sunnah twice. At the beginning and after you wash your face. I repeat, if you are used to washing your hands from the wrist until the elbow, that is not accepted. What is accepted from you, as mentioned in the Quran, is to wash a second time from the hands. So you wash the hands first, and then with that water, you go all the way to the elbows. You do it once. And then you take water the second time and you wash your hand again. And then with that water, you go to the elbows. And this is the second time. And then you wash your hand again. Again, wash it very well. And then you take water to the elbows. And then you do the same thing for the left. You take the water, you put it in the hand, you wash the hand, and then you link it to the elbows. Don't just go and wash your forearm from the wrist to the elbows. That wudu is not accepted. For Allah's sake, you know this in Al-Quran and you've read it many times. How many salats have you wasted now? Imagine you died now with that kind of lousy wudu. And this is only on wudu. It's only in wudu. My brothers and my sisters, this is why the worst moment of your life is when you come on judgment day expecting great qiyamul layl, great salat, great deeds, only to find that you have wasted your life building something that doesn't work. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells you, you are one of those people that are great losers in this life because you performed actions and you made great efforts in doing deeds and you thought these deeds were correct and nice when in fact they were rejected because you didn't listen to my commands. That certainly is the great loss. So my dear brothers and my sisters, from now on, do pay attention to Islam and what you do in Islam. A lot of people do something once and then they go on all their lives repeating it. So if they get it wrong on day one, all life is wrong. Just like that man who doesn't perform ruku. And I will speak about the mistakes that nullify as-salat and al-wudu and many other things. So my brothers, enough of a scare for this morning. Because you don't want to stand up on the day of Qiyamah only to find out that you had wasted your life building something that doesn't work for you in Al-Qiyamah. One of them is the wudu, as I said. I pray to Allah to teach me and you the relation that He will accept on the day of Qiyamah. And do not rely on the rahmah, the mercy of Allah, that Allah knows what's in my heart. So even if I suck big deal in the action, Allah knows that my intention was to do good. You will get zero, and you will get zero here. And then on the day of Qiyamah, you will be of those people who will bite on their fingers. Because on that day, there will appear to you from Allah that which you were not expecting. Allah Ghafur Rahim. You wait to see Ghafur Rahim. Ghafur Rahim is when you are eligible and you become eligible by seeking knowledge and implementing Islam based on knowledge. That's when Allah shows you His mercy. But you stay ignorant and doing something like a parrot, monkey see, monkey do, and then you come to me and says, I expect the mercy of Allah, I'll say, you will be one of those people that on the day of Qiyamah, it will appear to you from Allah that which you were not expecting. Correct your wudu, correct your iman, correct your Islam before it goes far away beyond help. Today you have help. When you die with six houses behind you and the worst wudu that you can present and thinking yourself you've done great, I'm really sorry. The six houses won't cut it for you on the day of Qiyamah, except a correct wudu. Allah, it saddens my heart. I pray to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to give you a good day today. Review any act of worship that you do. I will deal with the wudu. Pray to inshallah next week. I will start the videos and the channel on YouTube. And then I will do the wudu, the correct wudu, the correct salat, so that you get it spot on. Don't rely on what you have been taught, especially that nobody provides with you with the Arabic texts. Arabic less Islam is a very dodgy business. I pray to Allah to preserve us all and to make us of those who listen to the guidance and follow the best from it. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad. Subhanak Allahumma bihamdika nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Please do circulate this pep talk. It's dangerous that Muslims are doing that kind of wudu. My telephone number to join my group is 078-76-40-8735. If you have questions, send them on WhatsApp, or if you want to email me, it's eljalis, el.jales@gmail.com. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. This is again your brother Abdus Salam Abu Hanifa.